Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I am going to show you how to sort elements in array using built-in methods. Now, let me open my Eclipse. Now, inside my Java project, I'm just creating a new class and I will name it as sorting elements. Sorting elements. And let's take a main method, then finish it. So now I have created one class called sorting elements and which contains a main method. Now, I'll show you the first approach. Let's say approach one. So approach one. So in this approach, I first define an array which contains some values. Let's say array A is equal to, in the curly braces, let me have few values. Let's say 30 or some random order. Let's say 50 or 20 or 10, right? Or we can say 60. So these are the current elements I have. So 30, 50, 20, 10 and 60 in random order. So now we need to sort this particular array. So to sort this particular array, so we have a direct method is available, which is parallel sort. So in the arrays class, we have a method called parallel sort. So by which we can sort those elements directly. So first of all, let me print this array before sorting. And let me just print system.out.println. And I'll try to print the array elements before sorting. Let's say array elements before sorting. Now here, if you want to print array elements in the string format, I can just use one method called arrays.toString. Arrays.toString, and here I can specify a name of the array. So arrays.toString of name of the array. So this will print all the arrays element in the form of string. Let me just execute this. So right click, run as Java application. So once you run your code, now you printed all the array elements in the form of a list, right? So these are the element before sorting. Now I will sort these elements. So how to sort this element? So to sort these elements, I will use a method called arrays dot parallel sort. So there is a method called, in arrays class, we have a method called parallel sort. We can say parallel sort, parallel sort, P-A-R-A-L-L, parallel sort. So this is a method. So array is dot parallel sort, and here we need to specify the name of the array. So A is representing array. Now this particular method will sort this particular array, and this method is available inside the arrays class. So this we have to import from java.util package. Now once the sorting is done here, then again try to print the list of elements in the array. So here I will again try to print the elements. So array elements after sorting. After sorting. Now let's run this code. Run as Java application. Now we found the sorted order of elements. So 10, 20, 30, 50, 60. So this is a one approach. Using parallel sort method, we can directly sort the elements and we can print those elements here. There is one approach. So after that, I'll show you one more approach. Let's say this is also using built-in method. Let's say approach two. Approach two. So I'll just comment this one, the first approach. I'm just commenting the first approach. Now I will just redefining this array one more time, and which contains a number of values which are unsorted order. Now I need to sort them. So before sorting, I'll again print this list before sorting. Now I'm going to sort this element. So to sort these elements, we have another method called arrays dot sort. Arrays dot just sort. So parallel sort we already used. Now this is just a sort method. Arrays dot sort and specify the name of the array. Now this method also will sort this array. Now after sorting, I'm again printing the list of elements from this array. So array elements before sorting, array elements after sorting. After sorting, so this particular sort method will sort these elements. Now let us run this code. Run as Java application. Now these are the elements before sorting and these are the elements after sorting. So now we have done the sorting in two different approaches, by using parallel sort method, by using sort method, right? So apart from this, we can also sort the elements in the reverse order. For example, currently this particular method, sort and parallel sort methods, sorting the elements in the ascending order, right? Suppose I want to sort the elements in the descending order. That means in the reverse order, right? So how we can do that? So what I can do it, I can also use the same method here. Whatever method I have used in the approach to the same method. But here I'm going to show you in the reverse order. That means in descending order. Descending order. It's a descending order. Now, again, let me comment this code. Approach two, I have commented. Now, this is another, this is a reverse, reversing order or descending order. The approach is same, but this time we are sorting the elements in the descending order. Now, I have A, which contains the same number of elements and in the same order. Now, I'm printing the array elements before sorting. Now, here, arrays dot sort of A, and after printing this, it will successfully sort the elements. When I run this, we also seen this in approach two. So it is successfully sorted. But now I want to sort this element in the descending order. So that's my requirement. So to sort these elements in the descending order, we have to add one more parameter here. In the sort method itself, we have to add one more parameter, that is collections dot reverse order. This is a method. So collections dot reverse order. So the sort method will sort this array. Once it is sorted, this particular command will arrange those elements in the reverse order. Okay. But if I want to use this particular combination, it will not support collections.reverse order, will not support primitive data type. So that's the reason it's giving an error. If I just read that error, the method sort int of in and the type arrays is not applicable for the arguments. So if you want to reverse the order, if you want to sort the elements in the reverse order, then the primitive type is not supported, especially collections.reverse order method. Only if I use sort method, the primitive types are supported. But when I want to use collection.reverse order, then primitive data type is not supported. Then instead of this, we have to specify the derived type, let's say integer, right? So integer, then this array is again same, which can store integer values. But this time, this collections.reverse order will support this integer type. This is not a primitive type, right? Now, let us execute now. Run as Java application. Now we can see. So these are the random elements and it is sorted in the descending order. Now we can see 60, 50, 30, 20 and 10. So this is a sorted elements in descending order, higher to lower, right? So this is how we can sort the elements in ascending, in descending order or in the reverse order. So basically what this method will do is the sort method will sort this array in ascending order by default. But when I add this particular parameter collection or reverse order, it will make our the same list in the reverse order. So that's the functionality of this one, collections not reverse order. So how many ways we have seen? The first approach is using parallel sort method, we can sort the elements directly. And also we have to use sort. This is another approach we have. So directly you can use sort method to sort this array. Suppose if you want to sort this array in descending order, then we can apply collections.reverse order method. In that case, the array should not be in the primitive type. It should be defined as a derived type, integer, right? So this is how we can do the sorting by using built-in methods. All right. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.